What's good, YouTube? It's your boy, Blue Blood Sports TV, back at y'all with another one. So, undefeated, three-division world champion, former junior welterweight, undisputed world champion, currently the WBO welterweight world champion, who is widely considered by many to be the number one pound-for-pound fighter in the world, Terrence Bud Crawford. He, 37-0, 28 wins by way of knockout. He's 33 years of age. He stands at 5'8" with a 74-inch arm reach. Last time we saw him in the ring was November 14th when he defeated and stopped former IBF welterweight world champion British superstar boxer Special K Kell Brook in dramatic fashion. With that said, Terrence Crawford has been longing to try and secure a showdown with 8-division world champion, legendary, iconic Filipino superstar boxer Manny Pac-Man Pacquiao for quite some time. It first was being mentioned by legendary promoter, Top Rank CEO and promoter Bob Arum, who promoted at the time Terrence Crawford and Manny Pacquiao back in 2014. Then every year there following, Bob Arum was making mention the possibility of this fight happening and coming to fruition. And Terrence Crawford, well, he kept getting his hopes up high and securing this fight. Well, lately, Bob Arum has had more and more talks about the fight possibly coming to fruition. He actually stated that Manny Pacquiao agreed to face Terrence Crawford November 14th, but due to investment groups, falling through due to this global pandemic that we was dealing with and not getting a return on their investment, Bob Arum stated that those investment groups, well, they fell out, okay? And thus the reason why Terrence Crawford ended up facing Kell Brook as a replacement opponent. With that said, Bob Arum, he stated that it's a possibility we could get an announcement for a mega fight between Terrence Crawford and Manny Pacquiao for June 5th out in Abu Dhabi, okay? And that investment group was willing to put up $50 million. And then the initial talk, according to Bob Arum, the demand for Manny Pacquiao was that he wanted $20 to $25 million to stage the fight between himself and Terrence Crawford. Well, now once he, that being Manny Pacquiao, was privy to the information that an investment group in Abu Dhabi was willing to put up $50 million, that number changed. And then he stated that Manny Pacquiao now was looking, after he heard the $50 million offer was on the table, he now wanted $40 million. And according to Bob Arum, Terrence Crawford was willing to accept the $10 million. That would be ultimately an 80-20 split in favor of Manny Pacquiao. Well, now it's coming out because I was one of the people that questioned how could he accept such an offer, but he wasn't willing to accept such an offer when it came to his rivalry and the super fight, which is the biggest fight in the sport of boxing with undefeated, unified WBC, IBF, welterweight, world champion, superstar boxer, who was widely considered by many to be top three, top two pound-for-pound fighters in the world, in Earl the Truth Spence Jr. He, too, is undefeated, and he holds two belts. It makes for the biggest fight because they're both in their prime. Errol Spence is 31 years of age. They're both in their absolute prime. They're both undefeated, and this makes for the super fight in the division. Well, Errol Spence, he stated that he needed a 60-40 split to stage this fight, seeing as though he is the bigger draw outside the ring. His brand is big outside the ring. He's done three straight pay-per-views against former four-division world champion Mexican superstar Mikey Garcia, in which he did 350,000 pay-per-views. Then he did another pay-per-view immediately following that. Thereafter, against two-time welterweight world champion superstar boxer Showtime Sean Porter, and it was reported that did about 325,000 pay-per-views. Well, then he faced off against two-division world champion, former junior welterweight unified world champion, former WBC welterweight world champion, Danny Swift Garcia, and that did about 310,000 pay-per-views. That was his last fight. That was December 5th. So we know Terrence Crawford, he did two pay-per-views with Victor Postal, which reportedly did, according to Bob Arum, 60,000 pay-per-views in combined. And he did another pay-per-view with Amir King Kong, and it did 150,000 pay-per-views. So that's a combined 210,000 pay-per-views sold on the part of Terrence Crawford, combined compared to the numbers of Errol Spence, who's did 1 million pay-per-views combined, okay? So with that stated, Errol Spence said, I'm doing the bigger numbers. I need a 60-40 split. And Terrence Crawford said it had to be 50-50 or 60-40 in his favor. And it went back and forth. Then Terrence Crawford, well, he then stated he was done with the Errol Spence talk. He was done with that fight. It was in his rearview mirror. He had no interest in making a fight anymore because the goalposts continued to be moved and the 50-50 split came too late. He was asked about when he was on the Ak and Barak show. Shout out to Ak and Barak on Sirius XM Radio. When he was on Ak and Barak show and Barak, he asked him, you know, if you were offered 50-50 split right now, would you take it? And he said, no, I think that fight's behind me, which Ak and Barak was surprised that he stated that. He just said he was tired of the back and forth. So I was saying, if he's tired of the back and forth with Errol Spence, and this has only been talked about for the better part of a year and a half, then he should be done talking about the situation between himself and Manny Pacquiao. That's been the ongoing saga for the better part of 6 years. And now that if he's not willing to take 60-40 split again with Errol Spence, which is the biggest fight in the sport of boxing, they're going to have a rematch clause in which he'll directly be, you know, the A side should he beat Errol Spence, and the numbers will be tipped in his favor going into the highly anticipated rematch. But he's willing to take an 80-20 split with Manny Pacquiao. And according to reports, that's not true. Now, Bob Arum, he was featured on Barbershop Conversations with Fred and DB, in which he stated that Terrence Crawford was more than willing to accept the $10 million to face off against Manny Pacquiao, and that Terrence Crawford could not make more than $10 million fighting Errol Spence. Well, now the reports came out that Terrence Crawford simply was not willing to take an 80-20 split in favor of Manny Pacquiao, and that Terrence Crawford was hesitant because he didn't trust the investment group in Abu Dhabi that the offer was truly real. And according to reports, the Abu Dhabi investment group, they never were able to show proof of funds. And not to mention, Terrence Crawford wasn't happy with the split. So according to Team Pacquiao and according to reports, Manny Pacquiao had agreed and was willing and signed the contract for this fight. And Terrence Crawford, he refused to sign his portion of the contract because he wasn't comfortable with it. So with that said, that means that Terrence Crawford, well, then he's standing on his square all the way around the board. And it's not just with Errol Spence Jr. It's with everybody. It's the fact that Terrence Crawford, he knows that he's considered the best fighter in the world. Terrence Crawford is a 3-division world champion. He's undisputed at junior welterweight. He knows and feels like this is his worth. This is his big opportunity. He's 33 years of age. He knows that he'll be 34 years of age, September 28th. Father time is not on his side. And so Terrence Crawford, he does understand, as he stated on the special Relentless with Andre Ward, that he needed to secure a legacy fight and have a big revenue fight, okay? Now, Terrence Crawford, oddly enough, he is going to be a free agent in October. And I believe that Bob Arum was doing everything he can. Now, remember, Bob Arum, he came out and he stated that he lost so much money on Terrence Crawford in the last three fights that he could build a mansion in Beverly Hills from scratch, okay? Terrence Crawford, he seemed to have looked past it, but I don't believe that Terrence Crawford looked past it. I believe that Terrence Crawford, is truly, you know, viewing his worth. You know, I believe that Terrence Crawford looks at the situation with Errol Spence and he feels like they're on equal playing grounds. Although the numbers don't lie, the numbers tell the truth, that Errol Spence's brand is bigger outside the ring. And, you know, Terrence Crawford, he understands that Manny Pacquiao is a legend. He's an icon within the sport of boxing, but he still understands his worth and he understands what he brings to the table. And according to these reports, Terrence Crawford was not comfortable with an 80-20 split. He wasn't comfortable and truly on board in belief that this investment group was going to come forward and actually show proof of funds to get this fight to come to fruition. And I don't believe that Terrence Crawford was truly comfortable with going to Abu Dhabi. Now, we know that Terrence Crawford, for his first world title opportunity, he did go to the United Kingdom, the UK, when he beat Ricky Burns for the belt. Okay, but now I know Terrence Crawford, he may be looking at the situation with Manny Pacquiao and saying that if it's a close fight, I may not get the nod. You know, seeing as though I'm on foreign land, you know, he may look at it and say, I may not get the nod over there. as I will in the United States. And now there's talk that Manny Pacquiao has turned his attention to Errol Spence Jr. And that fight, they would be on board and agree to fight Errol Spence in the States on U.S. soil in July. So if that's the case, then why couldn't you do so against Terrence Crawford? And I'm sure he's not looking at being Manny Pacquiao to get an 80-20 split out of Errol Spence, because I'm sure Errol Spence won't agree to that. There's no talks as if there's a $50 million deal on the table for Errol Spence and Manny Pacquiao fight either. So is he looking to get $40 million out of that fight? Or is it a situation where he feels he can squeeze it out of Bob Arum because he don't like the track record and their relationship may have been somewhat rocky? So according to reports, Terrence Crawford turned down the deal. He wasn't comfortable with the 80-20 split, nor was he comfortable with the investment group. He didn't believe in it. And I don't believe he was comfortable going to Abu Dhabi. So let's see how this unfolds and plays out. Make sure you hit the like button. Drop a comment in the comment section. Let me know what y'all think. Y'all already know what it is. It's your boy Blue, Blue Belly Sports TV. Hate, like, comment, and subscribe. If you haven't subscribed, hit the subscribe button. Hit the like button. Hit the bell icon to get all the new notifications. Follow me on Instagram at Blue Belly Sports TV, all in one word. Y'all already know what it is. Shout out to the entire LDBC. Shout out to New Media. Shout out to Black Media Row. Make sure you like and share these videos. That's all I got for y'all. Peace.
You know what it is, your boy Jaden Kiss. Make sure you check out Blue Blood Sports TV. It's going down.